Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Thoughtful Leaders, an initiative under Thoughts on Education by CollegeDunia.com. CollegeDunia is one of India's leading education portals catering to students, parents and education industry players who are seeking information on exams, cutoffs, student reviews or even applying to colleges. This initiative is to enrich the user experience here at CollegeDunia.com and try to bridge the long view gap between the vision of the top management and the students and parents. Today, we have with us Dr. Meera Shankar, the director of Janaki Devi Bajaj Institute of Management Studies, SNDT University. Welcome to the show, madam.
Thank you. Thank you for calling me, having me here. Thank you.
So I would like to begin this session by enlightening our audience with a brief introduction of yours, ma'am. So Dr. Meera Shankar is working as a director at JDBIMS SNDT Women's University in Mumbai. She has worked as a trainer in the Oriental Insurance Corporation. Earlier, she had held various faculty positions at several other academic institutions as well as conducting other workshops at various places such as NEPI, IIT Bombay, URICM, Gandhinagar, Gujarat. Dr. Meera Shankar has over 22 years of active teaching, consultancy and research experience in the field of organizational behavior, human resources management, leadership, motivation, positive attitude, stress management, emotional intelligence and organization culture. She has authored two books on organizational behavior. To her credit, she has over 30 referred journal research papers and research articles. She has delivered over 30 presentations at several national and international level conferences, which includes Austria, Germany, Belgium, Japan, Canada, Indonesia, England, and South Africa. Her research work is indexed in Scopus, JSTOR, and EBSCO. She is a member of various professional bodies across the nation. Dr. Meera Shankar teaches course at postgraduate levels in the area of organizational behavior, HRM, organization development, behavioral dynamics in organizations, leadership, research methodology, and quantitative techniques using SPSS. We are really happy to have you, ma'am, in today's episode. Beginning with the interview, my first question to you is, you have been associated with the education industry for so long. What has kept you connected with the education sector? And how has been your experience so far with JDBIMS?
Okay, so I would like to give your second question first. My association with JDBIMS was an excellent experience. Being there or part of JDBIMS, I grew myself as an academician, as an administrator, or I would say that best part of my academic life in JDBIMS was that I have become a true teacher. I have understood that what true teacher is and what is our responsibility. So it is an excellent experience what so far I had with JDBIMS, and I would say that rather SNDT Women's University. And second question, what did you have?
What has kept you connected with the education sector?
Yes, it was my interest and my passion towards the academics, to the research work, and to interactive nature, where I feel blessed that I get opportunity every year to interact new dynamic students who are full with energy, passion, and very keen or eager to learn much more from us. So there, that keeps me motivating. I mean, I'm always motivated, energetic, to always being with the younger generation whom I'm teaching and interacting on a regular basis. So, I think nothing can satisfy me more than continuously being with them and know their requirement. Not only their requirement, through them, we also get to know what society in industrial way, corporate world wants from us. Because indirectly, we are training them, we are making them to go to the society, interact with the organization, corporate world, and wherever they are going to. So we keep on learning along with them. So that's a really motivating and satisfying experience for me. And that keeps me going on.
Okay, ma'am. So moving ahead to the next question. Being the director of Janaki Devi Bajaj Institute of Management Studies, how do you strategize about the key programs and plans for marketing and administration of the school?
Okay, if I can say about how we can brand ourselves. Of course, being a management institution, that itself a brand which we carry, and then this institution is named after the Janaki Devi Bajaj, who was the wife of Jamunalal Bajaj, equally competent motivated women who have who was rather, I would say, that freedom fighter, and she has contributed a lot to the society. So that's one motivation that we learned a lot from her life, and we also want to imbibe what she was, and that is truly reflected in our management courses. So what I say that we have to prepare here the women leaders who can become the change makers, entrepreneurs, and we also provide value-based education. That is the, I would say that core strategy of mine to develop my JDBMS institutions. And our focus always, it will be, I would say, on the women education, which gives us a clear purpose. You know, that says more than enough what I want to say. And we also want to empower women and help them to achieve their full potential in their life. So not only to the corporate world, but throughout their life, and they can manage the society well at large. And that is our strategy to train them in this way. That we want to train them in a very, very holistic way. And we don't want to prepare only for this competitive world of which you know, corporate world, but we also know to want them to become the good human being and who can add the value of the society's life. Could be their mother, maybe their wife, sister, whatever, along with balancing their work-life balance, I can say. That is the main objective we train them. And it's a very unique institution, I would say, that we are accepting all those challenges which are being thrown to us by the environment, I would say the external environment, that you can see that corporate world challenges. Along with that, with preparation of making them the world-class managerial, I would say that knowledge and activity we impart them, also we want to make them a very good human being so that tomorrow they can have a very good upbringing of their own children, of this family, in turn to the society. Yes, we aspire and desire to do that. I hope this answer will satisfy you. And if you want me to say more about it, definitely we want to make our student change agent of the society, not only for the corporate world, and lead from the front, no matter wherever they are. So that is the strategy we always adapt. And there are various areas of marketing, finance, IT, and human resources which we want them to train and sharpen themselves. I mean, they can sharpen themselves and they put into society back and make not only corporate or organization to grow, but the as India as a nation to grow. So that is my objective. That is our desire. And that's what we strategize ourselves continuously to, I would say that, to groom them as per the new requirement of the society.
Okay, ma'am.
When I say, you can think about the corporate world.
Okay.
Yeah, because it's totally management. I mean, it's not for the corporate or business world we're preparing them. We're preparing them for to face the challenges in the society, whatever it comes to them. Because as we know, I don't want to talk a lot about the women-related issues, but there are a lot of related issues which we prepare them to how to face. So that is also our desire and expectation, and we do also.
Okay, so this leads to the third question, ma'am. What are the factors that make Janaki Devi Bajaj Institute of Management Studies the best for students to opt?
As already I have told you, but I would say this is very unique institutions, only for women, very secured environment we provide to them. And I would say that education-wise, we are as competent as I would say that full of energy that any other institutions. Only difference we have, and there's a very basic difference we have, that we have taken the challenge to only groom, develop, and the managerial style and leadership styles to the women. So we are, I think, fulfilling the major aspect of the Indian society, grooming and developing the managerial skills among the women. And along with that, we, as I told you, that we keep on developing the leadership styles among the women. We always try to develop the skill of networking, interpersonal relationship, crisis management, team building, along with having the core understanding of the core finance, core marketing related areas, and IT sectors. And we also have the operational management subjects where, I mean, generally women, they don't opt for, but we'll be surprised that we have a lot of young women who opt for the operation management specialization. So all these areas, many more areas, of course, there's nothing or no area we have not touched upon which is required for the management students to know. So we cover up everything.
Okay, yes. Ma'am. So my next question to you is, how does the curriculum here at GTBIMS ensure that the students are being prepared for the future?
In that case, I would like to inform you that every year, after 2 years, I would say, we keep on changing the syllabus of our GTBIMS. So we change our curriculum as per the demand of the business world, corporate sector. And what we do is we try to not only we impart the theoretical understanding to them, but we imbibe the latest requirement, whatever corporate world has. And then immediately after 2 years, we incorporate the same. And whatever it becomes, you know, like redundant, of course, as per the requirement of the institutions, corporate world, we try to take out of the syllabus and then we put it new curriculum and we design accordingly. So that always keeps us updated as far as curriculum design is concerned. And our students, they go for the industry visit and they also go for the year-long research work to various institutions, to various corporate world, the business sector. So they also come to us and they also let us know that what exactly business world want from us. And then we have our own method, you know, that we have the BUS, Board of Studies, and then BOD. And through the various stages we pass through, and then we update ourselves and we go ahead revising and be, as you say, that app for the society.
Okay, ma'am. So yes. In continuation to the previous questions, I'd just like to ask one more. What are type of projects that our students are working here at GTBIMS?
Okay, project you are asking. So I would say about the this year, current year project. I would tell you the broad area what our students are working right now. Due to COVID, as you know, that the things have not been so focused, but still they could focus themselves a lot. So mostly their area of function was the mutual funds, then internet banking, health insurance, then organized and unorganized retail sector's problem and issues they wanted to understand. Then investment banking in telecom sectors. Then also they wanted to see the online loyalty of the customer behavior, because during the COVID, most of the things were transferred to the online. So they wanted to see how it is going to be impacted or to be impact on the customer behavior as well as to the sectors. Then HR point of view, I can say that there are various topics was being covered, which was related to motivation, morale, stress management, and then it was the crisis management. And then we wanted to understand the how organizational culture has changed during the past 1 year. And likewise, various projects the student they have done, and they have worked very well. And I would say that result is really commendable.
Okay, ma'am.
Some of the area I have told you, because most of the areas, I mean, I don't remember right now, I'm not able to recollect that, but yes.
Okay, ma'am. So my next question to you is, any insights you would like to give on how GTBIMS is more welcoming to students of different races or economic backgrounds?
Okay. For that, I can say that we are focusing more or greater, I would say, that multicultural understanding and learning. And if I may say that we are only working with the women, I would say that young managers, I want to be managers. So what more you want to ask me? That itself is, you know, like a kind of thing that we are continuously working to uplift the requirement of the women in this Indian society, where you hardly find out this type of a structure. To more, I would say that we already training the managerial aspects to the women. And another aspect is that our fees is very low. When I say very low, means as compared to other management institutions, it is very low and it is very affordable. It was kept only because that the women from all strata, who could come to us and get the education. There you will not believe, mostly we get the women students who are not able to afford the fees of other management institutions. And then once they qualify themselves here and once they start training themselves, they are the first place rather than the, you know, hugely paid, I should not say that some institutes are good or bad, but they are equally, they become equally competent and they are ready to compete the world. So I would say that this is the major idea which we, what we are trying to uplift. And what was the question? Racism and economic background. Yeah, mostly we racist, though I can't talk about it, but generally we follow the norms and rule of the government of India. So we have to have all strata of the only female student with us. And then as I told you that since our fees is very low, only for women, women who are coming, almost they are from the little bit economically compromised background. So yes, it is a very good cause which this institute is continuously trying to do and perform their act to uplift them.
Okay, ma'am. So my next question to you is, what are the benefits and career options for students after pursuing from this institute?
As I told you that this is the management institute. So most of them, they opt their career going into the business world. Could be the private sector, could be the public sector. Some of them, they go abroad to pursue their further studies. Some of them, they wish to continue with the doing the doctoral study in India itself. And then they become intern educationists or academicians later on to the various universities. Those who have opted for the business world to be there, I'm happy to share with you that some of them, they have joined the Microsoft and many more organizations in abroad, and they are doing very, very well. So all options are open for them and they choose that. And yes, they also have to play the role of motherhood. So they're what I keep on interacting with them. So successfully, they are succeeding in their life as a manager and as a homemaker also. So work-life balance is, it can be seen from the JDVM.
Okay, ma'am. So my next question to you is, what are some of the biggest challenges you see both for higher education in general and for JDVMS specifically?
If you are talking in today's term, I would say that due to COVID, the financial crisis and financial crunches are everywhere. So the students are not, they have yet not shown so eagerness, at least to the institute. I'm talking about other institutions, to go for the management studies because of the financial crisis I can think of due to COVID. Being women institutions, probably I can say that what is our strength can be the weakness also. Even girl student, sometimes they don't prefer to be in the only women institutions. They also may have their own wish, or they may have their expectation to join the other institutions where they can have the male colleagues with them. That is the challenge for the JDVMS, I can say. But again, we don't feel it as a challenge because we are always believing and doing the Sanskritasti Parashakti, which says that enlightened women is the source of energy and source of power. So we get our strength. I'm not saying that we are not getting the students, or number of the students are going low. But only challenge is that, yes, I mean, being women, women education, they face problem. Because if the students who are coming to take the admission to us, they ask for the education loan. And they have to face a lot of problem if it comes to financial status. And I believe that had it been boys, if they would go to some other institution, probably parents would organize much easily than for the female. Again, I'm not saying it is not a very general statement, but sometimes I feel that it may happen positive. And that is the problem and challenge we are facing. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. So my next question to you is, what would you like our audience to know more about Janaki Devi Bajaj Institute of Management Studies which they may not know.
Okay, here I will read my statement, which is mine only, so I can say. As I have told you earlier also, that J.D. Bam is the pioneer of women education. That is one of the most, I would say, that people should know about it, where we cannot market it being the government institution much more. So through you, maybe I would like to tell him to know. And then I want people to know this, that as an excellent management institutions, which is available in the heart of Mumbai. And what else can I say? That we have the beautiful and serene campus, which may surprise you if you come and visit to us. And and it is a very unique institute where only women can get enrolled. Again and again, I'm telling you, and empowered themselves through management education. They are well trained. They can be well trained to become young leaders or managers and constantly raise the standard of business sector. So we also raise the standard continuously throughout our education process. And yes, they can contribute in a dynamic development of the business world. We prepare them to be better among the best. Yes, you can see so. And we try to complete the motto of whatever motto just now I told you, that an enlightened woman is a source of infinite strength. We believe in that. That is why always we try to make them more and more strengthening themselves. And at JDBIMS, again, here we prepare them, and students are expected to learn and enrich themselves with life-turning experiences. That comes, the, you know, through the experiences they have to learn a lot, which enables them to reach a new height of their professional life. Along with hectic, busy curriculum activities, students are encouraged to participate in various co-curricular, extracurricular activities, where they do participate and do very, very well. And I would say that JDBMS has experienced academicians, well-trained people come to us who are from the industry and very many other places. And they share their extremely prepared and valuable knowledge with their students. And here we emphasize the teamwork. And you can say that we get synergy with maybe rich, poor, whatever background, whatever strata they are coming into. But after all, they become the women graduate doing the management. Mm-hmm. Continuous aim is to hone a student's skill to empower them with holistic business and value perspective of their compare with the other world. So we want them to develop their personality in a very, very fulfilling and a mature and a holistic way. So this is what we want from our own students, and that is why I want that through you, if many people will get to know, that will really be quite helpful to us. One of the best institution, I would say, that ours is, and our aim is to become not less than IIM for the women management related study. Let's hope that if we can fulfill our dream, or we can fulfill our hope, that time will tell us. Yes.
Okay, ma'am. So let me ask you the final question for the day. What valuable advice would you like to give to the student for them to have a prosperous career ahead?
For students, I would say that first of all, they have to keep themselves mentally and physically fit. They have to be emotionally rational. And in this world of competitiveness, we always say that this world is competitive world, cutthroat competition is there. But slowly they have to understand that they have to make themselves happy first. So all value-based learning, whatever they had, they should inculcate that within them. They should develop the right understanding about their own relationship. Could be maybe parents, maybe colleagues, maybe anyone. And human nature has to come first from within rather than competitive nature. Competition, yes, it will be there. And it has to be within you, and it has to be outside also. But that does not mean that they have to forget that they are the human being first. So that is my advice to them. And I also want to say that human mind should always be actively engaged with other activities as well, whatever they like and they wish to do, apart from doing their job. You know, life is one part of their life, is can be devoted to the office work or maybe corporate world. but they have their own, I would say, the surrounding life which should be happy. So they should do everything to make themselves happy, not only money-wise, but to maintain their own physical health, mental health, and right understanding with maintaining good relationship with everyone in the society.
Thank you very much. This was certainly an insightful session.
Thank you. If I may ask you, because I have not asked you anything, I mean, once if you have just phoned me, if you have done the entire interview, where you are going to show this and how I will get to know that how it was being done, because I'm sure it was extempo, so sir, something might have been to be needed to be revised or revisit. I'm sure you can do it. Can I get to know about it?
Yes, ma'am. So once the session is finished, I send it to my editing team. They do the needful edits, and then before uploading, I share it with you so that I get your approval. And then if there's any changes which you feel that they should be done, we do the required changes and then give it to you again. Once we get a final approval, we upload it in our portal and our YouTube channel, which can be shared with everyone. And you can also embed the video in your websites.
Okay. So, because I was not well versed with, you know, how much height our this computer should be kept and where I should be best visible. But I'm sure that I am fulfilling all those criteria of yours.
Yes, ma'am.
As I told you that this new era due to pandemic, it has put on this. Mm. So probably more maturity is required by age, by we are mature, but the maturity of IT related act, probably we need certain training. So yeah. I hope that it is your requirement.
Yes, ma'am. So yeah, I'll just finish it off the session. So everyone, this was Dr. Meera Shankar, Director at the Janki Devi Bazar Institute of Management Studies, Mumbai. On today's episode of Thoughtful Leaders, an initiative under Thoughts on Education by collegebrain.com. Thank you very much, ma'am, for giving us your time and speaking with us amidst a busy schedule. We look forward to interact with you again, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you.